In this lecture, we are going to learn various substitution design considerations. These are the various substitution design considerations. First is service condition, then primary system characteristics, then secondary system characteristics, then facility load or generation characteristics, then insulation requirements, then current requirements, and electrical studies. Now we will see each consideration in detail one by one. Service condition covers location, altitude, high and low mean temperatures, temperature extremes, wind loading and ice loading, seismic qualifications, area classification and contamination. Primary system characteristics covers local utility, nominal voltage, maximum operating voltage, system frequency, system grounding and system impedance data. Secondary system characteristics covers nominal voltage, maximum operating voltage and system grounding. Facility load or generation characteristics covers load type, average running load, maximum running load, on-site generation, future load growth and harmonic loads. Insulation requirements covers basic insulation level, insulator and bushing creepage, minimum clearances, phase spacing and arrestor duty. Current requirement covers rated continuous current, maximum three-phase short circuit current, maximum phase-to-ground short circuit current. Electrical studies covers power or load flow study, short circuit or device evaluation, then device coordination, then arc flash hazard assessment, then motor starting and transient stability, then insulation coordination and harmonic analysis. So these are the design considerations which needs to be taken care for any substitutions.